I'm breaking through. I'm disorganizing most of his troops. He doesn't have any skirmishers left. There's one here, but it's about to be, it's about to rout. But he's gonna kill off my, one of my last cav units. I think I have one more. Here we go. One more here. And I'm trying to go after his gen. I shot him for a bit, brought it down to 8 out of 18. His Ulan is gonna, take out my, I am gonna send a, Chasseur Cheval here to try and take out his unicorns, but he is going to stop it with his lifeguard foot, and his Ulans and this general staff and these electricians are going to take out my last cav unit here. So I am trying to break through. I am I'm going to fast forward just a little bit more. Just a little bit more, people. Almost there. Now I'm just trying to weaken up his troops so I could send anything left that I have to finish them off. I don't have any cav to make another breakthrough, but this is all he has left. That's it. 4, 5, 6, 7, 8 units left compared to my 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, 11 units left. And I count both of our general's bodyguards as well because they're used as a last resort cavern charge. Most players do that anyway. So I have way more units than him. I've been using my units a lot more effectively, so I am going to win the late game against my opponent. Now I'm about to meet up with Krasnikov. We're almost together. We're almost connected. I'm still using my howitzers. I'm trying to focus on this area just to break through. We are almost there. I ran out of ammo with the Swiss foot, so I'm going to use it as a melee or a meat shield. And I'm just getting it ready just in case he has any cavalry that flanks around, which he's going to do with this Light Dragoon. I could form into a square formation because I still can since they're at 79. And my opponent is going to retreat now. He sees it is futile to stay and die, but his units would last a lot longer in this forest than out in the open. Even if he does have a chance to get a key building, or I said key building, oh my god, I knew I would say it. Even if he has a chance to garrison a building with his line infantry, they'll still get destroyed. They don't have any ammo left to give off any counterfire, and I could just completely ignore the key building as well. I'm going to send my Swiss foot to occupy this building as well. He's going to flank around with this Light Dragoon. I'm going to see this, I'm going to form into a square formation sooner or later. Now, I'm connected with Krasnikov now. He wants to break through, he needs to. So he's going to send his Light Dragoons. We're both going to concentrate our howitzers on this little area so we can rout him. His 17th Jaeger Regiment is about to rout. And he is making a good breakthrough. His light infantry are standing toe-to-toe with these regular musketeers of Russia because their accuracy sucks so bad. That's how great Great Britain's skirmishers are. And that's why you need to take advantage of them. You need to. So we're going to break through this. So just to take pressure off this flank, Jose of the MH clan is going to make a full-out attack. He's going to send his melee troops in first. He's going to follow behind with some cav. Then he's going to do some counterfire with his line infantry and light infantry. Now, again, they're making the same mistakes, though. They're combining their light with their line infantry. I think your lines will do a lot more damage if you spread them out completely with your lights in the front serving as meat shields, giving out some fire as well, but ducking down so you don't do any friendly fire. Now, combining your lines with skirmishers will just open your lines up for an attack by these lancers, and you don't want that. Wrist is going to try and take off pressure from this attack by doing a counter charge, but he's formed into a square formation, so it's kind of useless, but he's going to send these lancers. He's going to direct his lancers instead from these line infantry onto these melee, but he's taking so much damage not only from these lights and these line infantry, but from these howitzers. They're so deadly. And these sanats are deadly as well. He's trying to shoot him, he's trying to send his lancers just to finish him off, but they're so good in melee, they're so good. Plus, the Ottoman player is using his line infantry and lights to shoot into this little blob of Prussian units as well. So he will win these fights. It is so much pressure that Riskard is about to lose. Now again, I'm going back to my flank here, there is still much more to come. I am sending my Swiss foot at the Mechion so I can follow behind with the majority of my army. I'm getting his skirmishers in sustained melee, and I'm just disorganizing his troops. I'm moving up my reserves now. My old guard, my Polish legions are all fresh, full in number, and they have so much ammo, and they're deadly. I am out to finish my opponent, but this time, like in the previous matches, it was always on my side. I was either the target or the main one to take up the damage and the burden of attacking. I was the only one to do that, but this time, it's Krasnikov's time to shine. He's going to cause a firestorm across this field. Now, I could whiff him, but he's much more ahead than me, so he's going to use his skirmishers to wreck a death path right down this field to the Ottoman player. Now, he is going to spare two guard units, two foot guards, to try and stabilize this flank. We can't lose this flank while we're attacking on the opposite. We can't. You can't attack and defend on two flanks at the same time. It's really too much pressure. We can't do that. Now, if you attack and defend at the same time, usually you want to attack on both flanks at the same time, cause too much pressure on your opponent. It's really tough to defend and attack because the part where you're attacking may be halted to send reinforcements to the side that's being defended. So it may halt your attack and your offense. So Kras is going to send some units that he had on the center. Ritzgrad is going to go behind with his foot guard and 8th Life Regiment to go around and flank them at the rear. So we're going to destroy these units. We're going to isolate them. We're going to overwhelm them with all these guards. Then we're going to focus on the remaining Ottoman players' units. But still, Ritzgrad is under a lot of pressure here, but he could hold off. He's in the forest. He has a lot of infantry here. He still has his howitzer dealing some damage to these infantry as well. So they're both doing the right thing. I think Kras really did help Ritzgrad stabilize this region here. So it's not broken. It's stabilizing. I think the only way they could actually defeat this is if they actually commit some units through here to flank and isolate this flank over here. Just to break through. And there's melee here too. I don't know why they didn't do that. They had enough. But they're being overwhelmed by all these fresh units of mine on the flank, so they're going to keep turning their flanks here. They're going to keep running, keep kiting. They just want to live. They just want to use their forces where they're strong, just like we do. But as you can see from the mini-map, it's stabilizing. Their attacks are halted. Their numbers are dwindling. They still have the key building here. Now, if we get rid of this key building, then we could focus on their center. We could isolate them, overwhelm them, but we need this key building. But there's a Samet Janissary in there. It's the best melee unit in the game. With 4 upgrades, it could beat an old guard in melee. And I'm flanking with my units through here in column formation so I could chase away the cowards that are running away. This is the last unit of my opponent. And they're gonna rout at the first sight of this old guard. My old guard is at full unit too. And I think around this time they know it's hopeless. They know it's hopeless. These three units are being surrounded. They're being meleeed as well. Ritzgrad's units, he is in a square formation. So he is going to defend against attack. And my god, they're taking so much damage from these howitzers. So much damage. They meleeed all those Ottoman units. And now we made a breakthrough in this flank. So now we're attacking on two flanks. So I'm going to take a few of my reserves. They ran out of ammo. I'm going to try and break this center. We want to close this gap. We don't want our opponents to have any breakthroughs. We want them to take any infantry they have on the front to reinforce an area that's being newly attacked. Just keep flanking. Just keep flanking. That's what I'm doing. He has a lot of guard units. I think he only has a few. Since musketeers are kind of decently cheap, he took quite a few of those, but he spent most of his funds on those 10-pounder unicorns, and they're kind of pricey. So even more pressure. Since I'm pretty much taking four of my 4 Russian units are facing my 5, so I have the numbers over here. Since half his force is facing the remaining force of mine, which are all fresh, full in number, and have ammo, Kras can overwhelm this section. I'm going to try and close the gap here. Same with Krasnikov. We're trying to fire artillery at this key building. It's taking minimum damage, down to 18%. They're using canister shot on these forces as well. Now, they will give up sooner or later. I'm just going to speed through this. They're going to go in sustained melee with Krasnikov. I guess Kras's guy was kind of mad or something, so he was like, F you, point man. I'm going to see if I could take out Kras instead. So, at this point, he's like, okay, I had enough running. So I thought he was going to go and sustain melee with me, so I was going to move back like, oh no, oh no. Kras was moving up as this was happening, so he was going to send all his units into melee against Kras. So instantly, Kras gets so many units to kill. So it's pretty cool that our opponents aren't going to like give up or anything. They're going to have some fun at the end. Like, okay, we can't beat you, but we're going to have a nice little melee fight. So look at all these blobs of Russians trying to go and sustain melee. Now, the bullet is a fine chap, but the bayonet, oh yeah, can't miss. We're even going to use hammer and ammo charge attacks with our general staff. I'm like, I want some kills too, so I sent in my general. I'm trying to wrap around, trying to get as many kills as possible. It's like, god damn it, I attacked so hard on my flank, I broke through it. God damn it, Crash, you're stealing so many kills. You don't deserve it. We're actually trying to break through here as well, but we're getting crushed by these melee. They're so strong. And that was a great game against our opponents. The Iron player is going to make a last stand in this this building. I say key building. So that is it. That is the end. Crash killed a lot. He stole a lot of my kills. But in the end, it was a great match against our opponents. This was the final match. Now we have to go into a round robin against Clan Long and La Royal Dragon. Team 1. La Royal Dragon had two teams. Team 2, Team 1. We faced Team 2 in the previous match that I showed on YouTube in two parts. Now we have to go into a round-robin matchup, and we've chosen to face our opponents, La Royal Dragon Team 1, first. We're going to face them on Homestead. They're the attackers. They're the hosters. And we'll see y'all then. Hope y'all enjoyed this.